Hi! It's time again to repaint my overgrown nails. I've spent the last few months keeping my nails short, so now that it's finally grown out, let's talk all things nail related, from the tools, nail care, length, shape, and color to approach my everyday gel nails. Right now, they're at a length of 1.5 centimeters, which I'd consider a pretty safe length for me to shape and shellac them. 1.7 is usually the longest I can grow my nails because that's where I typically reach the point of breakage. As for cuticle care and shaping, I've got a pretty standard nail kit with a cuticle trimmer to get rid of the excess dry skin around the nail, and then I'm going to use one of my glass nail files to shave down the harsh, uneven curvature of the nails and reach the desired shape. I'm someone with pretty petite hands, so I find this stiletto shape helps to elongate my fingers and can be very feminine and elegant. However, I do round them off more as opposed to the sharp point in V to lower the risk of making my nails too flexible to the point of potentially breaking. Now, your preference and lifestyle will determine the length, shape, color, and choice of polish. For me, I'd want a polish that doesn't take too long to apply and dry, but it also doesn't hinder my daily activities and will require constant and or expensive upkeep. So I'll keep my nails at a safe yet flattering length and shape with a light complementary color that suits my skin tone and the nail itself, because then it won't be so apparent to the naked eye as it slowly grows out or chips over daily use, which would allow a good amount of time for me before the next reapplication. I've gotten used to painting with gels, and I find wiping off most of the product onto the neck of the bottle leaves barely anything left on the brush, and that'll make for smooth, thin, and even coats. And I'll pick up more product when necessary. I find painting from the tip of the nail down to the base works best to avoid pooling too much product close to the cuticle. And what I also like about gel is that I don't have to worry about the stripes left by the brush, as it'll spread evenly if I just leave it for a second before curing it. For this round, I found that two thin layers of gel polish were good enough to bring a nice hint of coloring to my nails without being too bright or flat compared to the full opacity, or just a single layer of polish that would have been too translucent. As an extra step this time, I showed my cuticles some TLC by applying a nail oil once I was done. I should be oiling my cuticles on the regular, but I just don't do it, mainly because I just don't like greasing up my hands with product because it'll just get everywhere. And that is it. That is how I do my everyday gel nails. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.